Okay, so here we are in the Atomic Force Microscopy Lab at the Department of Materials Science in Cambridge, and I'm going to show you in this video how I set up the Atomic Force Microscope and use it to look at a sample of gallium nitride and just how quick and easy that is. So I'm going to start by turning on the software which will control the microscope. So the microscope is completely computer controlled and I just need to set that going. Takes a moment or two. Okay, once that's done, I can open up the big anti-vibration hood for the microscope. So the scanner itself is in here. I need to plug in the scanner, make sure it's got some power to work with. And I'm also going to turn on the air compression to raise the anti-vibration table. So that's now floating on a cushion of air. The next thing I'll do is align the microscope. So my first alignment will be to align the laser, which we use to monitor the cantilever, on the back of the cantilever. That's what I'm doing just now. Fine-tune that a little bit. Make sure I can see what I'm doing. So I'm just making sure that the laser's in exactly the right position for the measurement we need to do. Okay, and then I'm going to align the mirror that takes the laser to the photodetector, so that the laser spot's correctly positioned on the photodetector as well. Okay, so that's my basic alignment done. Now I need my sample. This is my sample. So this is a wafer, which is a sapphire wafer with a layer of gallium nitride grown on top. Should be a very, very smooth, shiny surface. So if we look at it in the optical microscope, we'll see very little. Here we're going to look at it in the atomic force microscope and hopefully see some of the details of the surface structure. I'm using a vacuum holder to keep it in place. Just making sure it's properly stuck down, and then I'll move it, got space, yeah, into position under the tip. So the next thing I'm going to have to do is get the tip very close to the surface so we can start to take our measurement. So what I'm doing first is defining the tip position. So now on my screen we can see the cantilever. Tune that a little in terms of position. Okay. Now that I know exactly where the cantilever is within the computer system, I can start moving the tip down towards the surface. So this is my initial course approach. I'm moving from about centimetre or so away to just a few millimetres away, and I'm monitoring that just with my eyes, watching the system. Okay, once I've done my course approach, then I'll do it a little bit more slowly, looking at it, looking at the computer screen to see where I am instead of the microscope itself.
idea to go to my sample. Okay.
So once I've selected the area of the sample I need to look at, which we can see here, there are really no features on the surface at this point that we can see in my optical microscope image in this box, then I'm nearly ready to start imaging with the AFM. I'm going to tune the cantilever to find its natural frequency of vibration, because I'm going to be working with a vibrating cantilever. And then we just rearrange things a little. We shouldn't be almost ready to image. So I'm going to close the hood so that I'm isolating the AFM from noise in the lab. And then do a couple of checks to check that my scan size and other parameters are appropriate. Sample I'm looking at. And then I just press a button and finish off the approach at the tip to the surface by letting the computer do the hard work of getting the tip very, very close to the surface. Hopefully, if I've done everything right, it will start to scan automatically in just a few minutes. It starts to scan automatically. The area of the sample I'm looking at does look very dirty, so I'll just move away slightly from that. Okay, there we are. So at that point, I am starting to image my surface. And then I can just start to optimize the microscope a little bit, but actually, already it's looking to my well-calibrated eyes not too bad. Now it's set scanning, and when we get to the end of the current scan, it will record an image of the gallium nitride surface. So, what we've got slowly appearing on the screen is a 5 micron by 5 micron area of the gallium nitride surface. We're scanning that for 512 lines, and each line is taking us about a second. So it's going to take a few minutes to build up an image from this point. But what we can see emerging on the screen are all these sort of grey bands. And each of those bands is essentially an atomic layer of gallium nitride. And then where the contrast changes from maybe light grey to dark grey, it steps down a single atomic layer. Or two atomic layers from one layer of gallium nitride to the next. So the feature sizes here, this is a scale which is going from minus 10 to plus 10 nanometers, so 20 nanometer height scale. A nanometer being a million times smaller than a millimeter. And these features we're seeing on the surface are less than a nanometer high. So typical step heights in gallium nitride are about half a nanometer if we've got two atomic layers, or a quarter of a nanometer if we've got a single atomic layer. So images like this are a very common thing we would take in my research group. This type of gallium nitride surface is the starting point for growing all sorts of devices. For example, if we were growing a light emitting diode, we build up the different layers of the light emitting diode on top of the surface like this. So the reason that I might, in terms of research, be looking at a surface like this would be just to check that it has the morphology we expect, which would be what we're seeing here. Check that there haven't been any problems in the growth of this part of the crystal, this basic gallium nitride layer, so that we're not seeing, for example, large holes in the crystal where the crystal growth has gone wrong. Check the surface is clean and that it provides a good starting point for the growth of our real device structure. So if I'm working on LED growth or LED related materials in the lab, I might want to take a wafer like this straight out of the crystal growth system, which is upstairs. I could bring it down here and I could provide the information back to the crystal grower within maybe 10 to 15 minutes that this was a good quality wafer that wasn't showing any excess defects or problems, and then they could go on with the next phase of their research work. Example, we have got a little bit of contamination here, which is not really what we'd like, but that's because this is an older wafer that's been hanging around in the lab for a little while. The vast majority of the wafer is still quite clean and nice. that's our image completed. You can see that actually if we need a little bit of post-processing so that we can really see what's going on. Just do that in there. And then, so this is our gallium nitride surface. We can see a little bit of contamination, we can see atomic height or two layers of asymptosis, we can see a few little tiny black spots which are defects in our surface. And you can see that getting to that was really, even though what we're seeing is in the height direction, an atomically resolved image, was really not a very challenging thing to do. And that's the power of the AFM. It gets us information on these very, very small scales really quite straightforwardly and easily.